Meet Nathan Essel. He's a teacher at heart, an ordained minister, and an expert in linguistics. Sarah, Nathan's wife, is a nurturer, a trained nurse, and talented provider for her family.
This is the steam area, but there's got to be apes.
But these two willing servants have now taken on a new role. In the summer of 2003, the Essela family moved to the West African country of Ghana to help a community build a house. Not a house in the literal sense, but a spiritual home in which to dwell and seek protection. They came to build a Bible. This small northern village called Naswan is home to the Komba people. Contrary to what our Western standards might suggest, these people have a lot. They have a rich cultural history, a strong work ethic, and a genuine friendly nature that makes everyone feel welcome. This community even has an established Christian church with a committed congregation and gifted leaders. But what the Komba people lack is a Bible in their own mother tongue. They have no access to the living Word of God in the language of their heart.
The people do not have God's word in their heart language. Even if they have God's word in their own, in their heart language, they cannot read.
But it doesn't mean that from now on going we'll always do it this way, because, you know, it's our house.
Imagine reading the Bible in a language other than your own, and then trying to understand and share what you've read. Imagine what might be lost in translation, literally.
So if our people get to, our local people get to their own local language to read and write, I think it will help more than the English way, because you know our area here, education is poor, because not many people can read and write.
Driven by the urge to experience God's word in their own Komba language, local leaders reached out to an organization called Lutheran Bible Translators.
After many prayers and asking questions around them, we sent in a request to LBT, see whether they will be able to solve these two problems for us. So that is where this project has come in.
This is how Nathan and Sarah came to Ghana, with the hope of helping to develop not only the Komba Bible, but the written language itself. And that process has begun. Nathan works closely with Komba volunteers from all over the region in an effort to make the most accessible, accurate translation possible. Working in conjunction with Nathan, literacy specialist David Federwitz seeks ways to involve the Komba people in building their own written language and literacy skills.
It's very helpful to me and then Komba as well, because the training I've received here, I'm able to use this training so that the Komba too will be proud of themselves. If one see how I'm doing this, they are very happy to see that a Komba child or a Komba son is doing this. So whenever they see one doing this, they may say, oh, my son too can even do better. But that's the truth, the training that I've took. And it is my pleasure that I still work with the Kulibi tribe to bring God's word into Lukon.
Here in Naswan, building a house, or ini in Komba, is not just a project for the owner, but rather an undertaking for the entire community. Women bring water from the river. Young men dig into the earth for mud. Children help to form the mud into balls and take them to the skilled masons who join each piece to form a wall. Everyone has a role in the creation of a house, and everyone takes pride and a sense of ownership in the finished product. This is the hope for the Komba Bible Translation Project, that the local community would adopt the project as their own and discover that same sense of pride as they build their own Bible. Even in his role as the linguistics expert, Nathan knows that building a Bible does not begin with translating the words. Like a traditional African mud house, a Komba Bible will not endure unless a firm foundation is established. In this case, the foundation consists of the local community and the individual relationships that make it strong. Since their arrival, Nathan and Sarah have therefore boldly sought relationships and involvement in the community. Their children, Carissa and Annika, play all day long with Bachisu and Aliyah. Sarah goes to market with her friend Elizabeth. Nathan visits with local pastor Isa and helps him repair a wall in his home. The family attends church together and frequents the nearby Keto stand.
When the team came, Dave and Nathan came to the north, we see the partnership also where they are working with our pastors and evangelists and our church members. It's a very healthy sign, which we appreciate very much, because where you have a teamwork and then the partnership is working, it becomes very healthy.
As the SLS get closer to the people of Naswan and the foundation of relationships is reinforced, the shared vision of a lasting, meaningful Bible translation comes into focus. This is the foundation on which Nathan and the translation team can build a solid spiritual house, a Bible in their language, for the Komba people to live and dwell in the living Word of God.
Someone can even don't know how to build a house, but because of the people, the brothers, he will talk to them, come out and help me to put my house. They know that he can't do it, but they will come out and help him to put the house for him. So that's why we need to tell them, this is what the Bible is for we, the Christians. But help us to also put it together in our own dialect so that we can use it.
When they have this language in their own language, they can speak, they can preach, they can talk about it in their own language, they remain in the truth of the gospel. And the gospel is the one that saves, the gospel of Jesus Christ.
My 10-year daughter said, "That why is this old man smiling?" Then I saw that the old man was holding a New Testament translation. Even it was Luke, I could tell it was a different language, but I could tell that it was the book of Luke. So this old man was reading it in his own language and he was smiling. So I told the people that one day, people will smile here. People will smile like this old man who was smiling in the picture. They will smile. Even though there will be struggles and ups and downs, but finally they will smile. Because if God speaks to them in his own language, they will smile.
Taking that Bible verse about...
The building process has just begun. As Nathan and Sarah continue to develop new relationships and work toward a complete Komba Bible, they rely on the continued financial and spiritual support of many American friends and churches. In building this house, Nathan says the true mortar that holds it all together is prayer from around the world. God is the master builder. And it is the Esala's hope and prayer that the Komba people can intimately experience God's love through the scriptures.